greetings for those, and welcome back to the Elder Scrolls Daggerfall. Today's objective, if you would like to call it that, is to complete the Prince mission, or is it the Beast? Yeah, the Beast. It's not a bugbear, the Golden Market Daily after all. But we basically have to ask around, and I did spoil the game for myself, but what we basically have to do is ask around until we find this. The staff maiden, who would be willing to point us to the right direction, and so that's pretty much it. I mean, we help her with the quest, and she tells us more about Melisera's letters, or, you know, Barenziah's letters, rather, and what Melisera did with them. But anyway, this is a compulsory quest, and the thing is, we can't exactly ask these people about it, and judging from what they have told us, you know, this guy tells us, I do not exactly have all the blessing to go into these areas yet. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to try going there, and if the guards start attacking me, then I'll just go ahead and, turn away, I guess. It's going to be like a process of trial and error, so let's just go and save you. You see, when it comes to politics and Daggerfall, it's a very fine thing, and we can't exactly, you know, mess it up as easily. Aubk-i does not really have any more customers. Let's try talking to the king. I could use the services of someone of moderate talent, above average discretion, and willingness to assume the position of a lowly courier for 461 gold pieces. Are you that person? Nah, not really. I just wanted to talk to him for, you know. Now I'm gonna ask this guy about. Things were people crusaders. Yeah, I can't really ask him about. He's just mostly the guilds and stuff. That's it. Yeah, I could ask him about the painting, but I do not suppose I can get Royal Blessing to go searching through these halls, after all. And, I can ask him about Melisera. So I guess the advice that was given to us by Lutin, or rather was it? It was the other woman. Barenziah's daughter, wasn't it? Who gave us the advice. Sound advice, actually. So our player takes it to heart, so yeah, I suppose we should be polite in asking Mobar about them. Hail, good Mobar. Can you tell me where I might find Melisera? Who gave you permission to speak to me? I know where to find Melisera, but now I'm disinclined to tell you. Yikes, okay. What about you, good sir? Kirtwell, of course. Alright, because they're royalty, of course, so. Fair day to thee. I hoped you might direct me to Melisera. How amusing. This not peasant is looking for Melisera. I'm not about to lure myself by answering. I see. Well, I would assume that my last quest at least might have raised my reputation just a little bit, but I suppose that is not the case. Melisera, your question presupposes that I feel an affliction for you, which I don't. Everybody's quite rude, I wonder what happened. Why would I help a complete stranger, especially one with your reputation? Okay, this is glad to tell you, no permission to speak to her, apparently. I'm guessing people are pretty touchy about this topic of Melisera. What do I know? I don't want to talk to you anymore. How's that? Well, what do I know? I don't want to talk to you anymore. How's that? That's basically what it was. The lower classes get lost so easily. Go, I think they have one black gate. Black gate, huh? Is that a hint? Or is that a prison? I really can't tell. I'm certainly the wrong person to ask, Grimfangs. Oh yeah, I forgot to be polite with her. Grimfangs? I seem to remember some courtiers speaking well of you. Sadly, I can't help you with the Minnesota. Right, so we only have a few options here. There's a night date in front of the store. I think it's a night date. A battle mage, excuse me. So yeah, it's unlikely that we would be allowed to enter there. However, this door here is continuing. Yeah. It's unguarded. We've been trying to do this. I'm just gonna go ahead and save beforehand. The platter of pots and pans something. Yeah, this looks like the lady that we're supposed to talk to. And your name would be Cyssanda. Cyndassa? Wait, what? Yes, Cyndassa. Hey, if I told you I could give you a bit of information, let's see, about that letter of milady, would you be interested there, Grimfangs? I thought so. Now mind you, I am giving it away. Before I scratch your back, you gotta scratch mine, do you? Sure. My name is Cyndassa. Daggerfall. Okay, Cyndassa Daggerfall is a name. I guess, I mean, people back then were named, you know, like their first name used to be their only name, and then they would append the names of their cities or their professions to them to make, you know, the status clearer. So I suppose that makes sense. I'll tell you everything I know, but I don't need to remind you that there ain't no such thing as free info to our Grimfangs. I'm just a maid to Her Highness, nothing but a fleck to the world, and my needs ain't big. I need this werewolf done in. I know just where it is, some oblivion forsook hole called the Circle of Gwynyssa. Sounds like your home, Cyndassa. I can't tell you why, but it's important to me that the werewolf gets put out of its misery. I'll wait here for 10 days for you. That ought to be plenty of time. I suppose it will be. Okay, so... Circle of Gwynyssa. Right, so we got a quest, and let's proceed then. Circle of Gwynyssa. Pretty sure if I tried entering any of these other rooms, I would have the guards attack me. And hopefully I have a blessing to explore these chambers afterwards. Oh, sorry, that is not what I meant to do. What I want to do right now, though, is check on the status of my weapons. Sorry. Oh yeah, I also got this thing, it's an orcish mace, so yeah, I'm pretty glad I got it. I think I'll be using that right now. I'll pull out my wagon and I'll remove the axe from the wagon. I also saw a Daedric axe, but it's like 47,000 gold and I just don't have enough money for that. So, Circle of Gwynyssa, let's travel there, I suppose. Should be a Daggerfall, since it's only giving me 10 days to travel. Wait, the Circle of Gwynyssa. two days to travel back, should be left for the comfortable 6 days. Wood spoke. I think that's the entrance, let me just make sure that I am in the pit. Yes, I am. Now then. And the music changes. That's how you know that you are entering wild territory. Ah, yes, there's the entrance. I like this. I like dungeons of these kinds where the entrance is right in front of you. Now, I hope this is not like a huge dungeon that I'm gonna have to explore a lot. I mean, exploring this game is fun, but it quickly get very tedious. And right off the bat I can see two paths. I'll just clear out the right side of the dungeon first. I see a rat. If only there was more, you know, use for this guy. Little bad. 333 gold pieces, amazing. And yeah, let me just go ahead and check this room for any. There are two doors in this room. I wish we did, but let's keep going this way, I guess. Okay. I mean, opportunities like these are a great way to improve your hand to hand. And in case an enemy pops up on the other side, all you do is just, well, re-clip through your inventory screen so that it doesn't take time to equip. Now, I wonder if this is going to give me anything. Nothing, I suppose? Yeah, nothing. One hit. That's all it took. I don't suppose this guy has anything here. It does not. Now, what I like about Daggerfall in comparison to Arena is how they tell you that the body has no treasure. Because back in Arena, they would not do that. They would literally just, you know, make you click on it a few times, and if you couldn't, like, manage to find any treasure, that sort of meant that there is no treasure on the body. And that's not the case in Arena. They clearly tell you what's what ever since the very beginning, and yeah, perfect. Even the music and atmosphere and everything in these games is just so anxious. That was a rogue. Took a lot of hits actually. Didn't expect a rogue to be that strong. Or equipped with an axe at that. So yeah, but that's just me. I think I've seen this dungeon model once. This one definitely looks like a warrior of sorts. Maybe a barbarian. Yeah, barbarian it was. I'll be taking this from you. Is this elven longsword? Let me keep it with me. I can sell it for some money. Let's see. Plus one to armor rating, very poor helmet. Essentially of no use. Let me just go ahead and save here. You know, in case things go bad. And the dungeons in Daggerfall is just so vast and convoluted, you know, it's such a hassle to explore all of them. Just that in Arena, one of the things that, like, they goofed up in many ways, the devs, while making this game, but one of the prime ways and just the prime examples of them goofing up is essentially when they pretty much... This is literally a copy of the dungeon module I've already been through. So, right off the bat I can tell that it's going to be pretty confusing, to be honest. Or at least I just feel like it. Somebody here, for sure. Okay, naked dude. This one is definitely barbarian, isn't it? Archer? Why was he naked though? Steel longsword? Not worth much. I'll take this. Yeah, poor health. Pretty poor health. So yeah, one of the ways that they goofed up with Arena is... Sorry, Daggerfall is the fact that... Well... your weapon? The material of your weapon pretty much dictates your hit chance, and if your weapon is of a higher grade like this, right here, that's what dictates my hit chance, not how much agility I have. It was supposed to carry over into agility as well, but the way the game is structured, it never did. And I think we've reached the end of the road for now, for here, for this part here at least. I do not think there are any hidden doors there, none that I can see anyway. I will go back up in a bit after exploring this section. I think this might also lead to a dead end of sorts. Or it'll just go deeper. Why is this tiny little cell-like thing here? Makes me very suspicious as to whether there are any hidden, you know, things here. This torch seems to do nothing, so I guess that's not the case. Let me just go and save here. Now, no matter how strong you get in these games, it's always a good idea to keep saving. Because otherwise it can, like... Is this a hidden door? No, it is not. Yeah, you never know when you're gonna die, so it's always a good idea to keep saving in these games. Is that one of the werewolves? Oh no, it was just a werewolf. I guess these were both werewolves. I'm looking for a werewolf though. This body has... Of course it does not. It's a werewolf, right? I mean, if it was, like, just a boar, it might actually have treasure. But yeah, let me keep this in my inventory as well. Steel light with right ball from. Not bad, not bad at all. Let me see what you have. A lot of alchemical supplies. Too bad I'm not an alchemist. So this was a dead end, but interesting one. I mean, I got excited for a second there. Like, these Daedric weapons are not Daedric, I mean, this is Aubk-i, and I think this is like the best tier weapon that you can get in the game, but these weapons are amazing. They say best tier because further weapons, like the further along the line you go, the weapons just keep getting, you know, more expensive and heavier, but don't really give you the same satisfaction for using them. Spider also died. Good thing I didn't waste a potion of reaction on him. This is also one of the things down, I suppose. Now where do I go from here? Let me go here first. There's something in there, in the crate, I feel like. Sometimes, I've heard that sometimes objectives can be hidden inside crates, like these cages. So, I am a little curious to check it out. Plus 4 to armor rating, plus 4 to armor rating, no difference. I think this is sort of a wraith. I feel like. Well, there's definitely something inside the crate, but. Because I think I can see some flickering eyes or something. Just can't make it out. Maybe just save here. Okay, this dungeon module. Pretty pointless module, but... Hey, usually if somebody's hiding in here, they'll come out. But yeah, pretty pointless module for the most part. Doesn't really have much at all. This module is also pretty pointless. Okay, so this way goes clear. This way goes back up. Or let me check this way. Let's see where this leads us. To a whole lot of nothing. At least this dungeon isn't... I mean, it is vast, but it isn't as labyrinthian as some of the other dungeons are. In the sense that... okay, a spider, that's new. Like, this doesn't have long, winding passageways and roads that, you know, lead you to, like, vastly different ends of the dungeon. Is that a boar or is that a werewolf? Oh, a werewolf. I got excited for no reason there. This guy was just, you know, trying to keep warm. I feel sort of feel bad for killing him. I'll go there in a bit. First, I want to check out. Okay, let's go there. I'll go down there as well, but first I wanted to make sure that everything, at least on the same level, was clear. Because otherwise, keeping track of things can get pretty difficult. Okay, so where did it come from? Seems like I have been everywhere here. Yeah, I have been here, like, to all the places here. So I suppose I will go further down then. The poor guy was just being warm and I killed him for that. Makes me sad, actually. Yay, a werewolf! Do you know how you can tell that they're werewolves? By their sound, they go oink. They snort like piggies. Instead of going grrr. like doggies. Oh no, what a grim sight to greet you. Oh, hi there. Come here, dear. Let me kill you. I wonder why none of these archers can even stop us. No wonder she was doing so much damage. Like these female archers. Chain Greaves, Chain Furious. Not bad, not bad. I'll keep it. I'll keep it with me, and yeah, that's pretty much all. There are enemies nearby, of course there are. But let me just go ahead and save the game here. It's always wise to keep checking all your corners because... Oh, hi there. Why are you running? Why are you running? I mean, the most curious archer I've ever seen. Guy doesn't even have a bow. Like, you can actually get an over and compared with bows pretty quick in this game. So I'm guessing this was just like a secret passageway. Yeah, I'll rest until I'm fully healed. Or until an enemy shows up. Pretty sure that's not gonna be anytime soon, so... I guess I'll completely explore this area first. Can you please hit the switch? Thank you. Unless it comes with like an enemy in there. In which case, fuck you. I will definitely be checking this area out as well. Okay, use the dungeon module. I'm guessing nothing is in here either. Before I change levels to go down even further, I would like to just, you know, explore the entirety of this level first. Yeah, so basically it's important to keep checking in these areas because, well, a lot of times your objective can be hidden, you know, in one of these little niches. Happen to be quite often. Like, this might not be the guy that you're looking for, but whatever opened the door might just be. Steve Warhammer. I'll take this. And I'm guessing other chain boots, no. It's sort of strange how similar chain boots look to elven boots. Wasn't there anybody in here? Was there like a sword here? Okay, it's a sash of boot, right. And I'm guessing this is not a sash of boot. Just a very grim scenario. Typically these can lead you into like secret areas of the level. And yeah, I can't. These areas are pretty damn tall, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna save the emergency slot here, and I'm gonna try climbing up, and let's see where this leads us. If it leads us to, like, an, you know, to just an empty goose chase, I'll come back, essentially. It's usually the case that this dungeon module is pretty much fixed and doesn't really change much. So I do not think I've been here before, but I don't mind being here. Especially in the company of this lovely, lovely woman. Barbarians, man. Super difficult to defeat. I would love to have increase that look like this. Even there are any. Oh hey, another pile of loot. These areas most definitely have loot, but I'm not sure whether they ever hide any objectives in these areas. Okay. That sounds like something strange. I have no idea what that is. Sounds very strange though, whatever it is. Okay, yeah. The running jump. Okay. I do not think I've been here either, but something tells me it connects to this area here. So let me just go ahead and complete the connection. Ah, yes. Yes, it does. So this is essentially the area that we were about to come from, but we never did. There's also another place down there, and yeah, pretty grim sight, to be honest. Pretty grim sight. I sort of want to go here and explore now, now that we've established that there's nothing up there. Unmute. I don't know why my stealth skill is improving. That sounds like a werewolf. Yeah, I don't know why my stealth skill is improving. Just a werewolf. Another werewolf. Okay, so those were werewolves that I got, that I was hearing. But I think I heard a werewolf as well. And yeah. If it was indeed a werewolf, that would be brilliant. I think this is the area that we, you know, the door that we opened back there. Yeah, so it basically leads us down there. That is definitely not our target. So we'll just leave a bee. Now we can go up from here, or we can continue exploring this side. Which leads us to yet another place of, you know, another maze-like place. Which, huh. This dungeon is large. This dungeon is large. I'll get there. I'll get to you. I'll get to you as well. First, before changing levels, I just try to tend to complete the areas. Although, like, complete the area completely, like, finish covering the area before I change levels. That way, it's more, you know, congruent. I guess the my sneak skill is improving primarily because I'm guessing it's because I'm crouching a lot to pick up loot. I mean, it's the only reason I can think of. Yeah, the useless module. That module should also be useless if this follows the same, you know. Yeah. That is sadly not something that I can loot. So we can go here, I think. No, that's where it came from, right? And the only place we can go is upstairs here or upstairs there. Or downstairs here. I think we'll go downstairs first. Let's see how deep we can go. And then see what can be done about this place. Because, wow, this place is huge. And is this real? Nope. This has a hidden door here. Right here. Usually objectives are not hidden behind hidden doors. Because if they were Mrs. Shark, Mrs. Frost, not really interested in either of those potions. You can keep them. Thank you. Yeah, I mean, you can see the faint outlines of hidden doors, but you just like need a very discerning eye for that. It's not that hard to sort of surprise me though. Find hidden doors in this game. Let's see. Nothing of interest. This seems fancy. This maze is amazing. I mean, look at how often it hits and how easily it kills them. Ooh, ground shield. Let me keep this. Oh, okay. Let me drop some stuff then. Maybe this thing. And let me keep this with me. Let me equip the gold. Let me find more information on this. Shame boots, of course. Elven greaves. I wish I could remove this. I can. That's amazing. That is amazing, honestly. Now, I'm getting pretty full with loot right now, so I better find a way to... Oh, they actually found a use for this dungeon module. Nice. Put some decorations up in there and give me more loot. I do not even have space for that gold. Now, the question here is, do I really want to drop any of this stuff? Oh, I completely forgot to equip this. This will give me +2 to armor rating, but it has some special bars. Oh yeah, I forgot to sell these as well. I probably should do that the next chance that I get. I cannot access the wagon from here, of course. And yeah, ingredients, I might as well go ahead and remove this because I could not really care for it much. Ah, and that gave me enough strength. Oh, maybe it was the Aubk bracelet that gave me enough strength to, you know. Like, considering the fact that I was not wearing the Aubk bracelet, in the game was sent to carry more stuff, but considering the fact that I was not wearing the Aubk bracelet, it's quite amazing how... quickly this Aubkish, you know, mace just dispatches people. Amazing, really. Yeah, so at this juncture, I think that's where we came from. Have we gone here? Yeah, it was more or less a dead end. Let's go back this way. I'm really trying to find like a suitable schedule for me where I can game every day. And I think, I was sort of late today. I was supposed to be done with this an hour ago. But I decided to... let's just go ahead and get this over with. Surprise me there. Like, if this game had more modern graphics, it could easily have become like a horror game. This module. This is one of the modules where sometimes... well... a wraith attacks you. Hello, Rogue. Thank you for dying. Now show me what you've got. It's strange how they make that sound from time to time. It's the first time... oh no, it's not actually. I was about to say it's the first time I've found a magical item. In like a raid, but it is actually not the first time I found a magical item in the raid. There have been times before when I've found them. Just... yeah, one of those pieces again. This torch does nothing, of course. And there's a dead animal there. I wonder what did the poor animal do? I do not think this thing has a hidden door on it, but yeah, it does not. I mean, you can never be too safe, right? I have to confirm. This sort of looks like a hidden door. It's not. So, the way hidden doors work on this game is that the outlines don't match up properly. That's when you know that it's actually a hidden door. Is that literal thunder? I could sell that. Info, our boots. Thank you for dying. Let me grab whatever you have. That looks fancy. I wish everything else would look, you know, just as aesthetically pleasing. Because I'm sort of sad that they don't add trims to the rest of the stuff like that. I realized that I haven't saved in a while, so let me just go and do that. And let's see. Where else can we go? I do not think we have been down there. Now, I can run in dungeons, so I just don't prefer doing that because, well, it drains your stamina quite a lot. So yeah, I've been trying to find the proper schedule that I can sit and record every day. I thought maybe 10:30 to 12 would be a good time, or, you know, in the night, I mean. And or maybe 11 to 12 might be a good time, but today I got quite super late and it's already past 12 by the time that I'm sitting to record this. So yeah, this is one way to level up your hand to hand. Damn, as soon as I open that door, Yeah, let me equip the mace. I'll be here until then. As soon as I open this door, I mean, you live up to your reputation, sir. You are definitely a rogue. I'll just... okay, let me dispatch them. Probably here, the enemies. I'll come back to you. Not that I need to rest, but yeah, I just feel more of comfort than I do. Werewolves are no challenge for me, just that I would actually like to find the objective. Don't tell me this one is also an archer. Yep, it was. Elven Fail. Can I remove this? Yes, I can. I guess that even once this bracelet breaks on me, I'll still be able to... well, pretty much just keep using the... like, I don't think I would have to drop any of the things that I'm carrying to be able to carry this bracelet. Strange. Spider. Wait, I'll come back to you. First, let me go ahead and explore the rest of the space. These crossroads. Sounds like a werewolf. Why can I not? I am about to get swarmed by enemies. This is going to be tough, because even those other enemies are going to be right behind me. Yep. I mean, it was very unlucky, but I guess it is. It just is what it is. Whew, that was difficult, but four human enemies in the room. I'm impressed by myself. 170 gold pieces. It's definitely the boost from long shirt. Of course, powers alone, I'll remove that as well. And if it is useful, I'll use it. The power, I mean. No, not that. I want to look at your friend. I could sell that actually. But yeah. Let me take all the gold. That's like the least of whatever I'm gonna take from you. And let me remove this as well. Let me see what this is worth. 580 gold. Yeah, let me remove this as well. God, I really need to get to the damn dungeon entrance as quickly as I can, because I'm gonna run out of space like this. Let me go back here and rest now. So far. How about over here? Time to save again. So yeah, today I'm just gonna go ahead and play from, you know, 12 to 1. Let's see how this goes. Because I mean, I want to be more consistent with my, you know, gameplay. I wanna consistently do it. I don't know how fast it. I feel somewhat bad. Okay. I really hope I haven't got like a very bad disease. Ebony saber. Adamantium broadsword. Let's go. I am taking these. Oh, I don't care. I'm gonna remove this and I'm gonna take this. Because there's no way I'm passing up on that kind of loot. You have been poisoned, right. So I think I've got something to cure poison. Silent Eyes, Battle Axe of Featherweight, Round Shield, Long Shirt, Silent Eyes, Diamond of Venom Antidote. I guess we can use this. Am I still poisoned? I'm healthy, right. Good, great, great, great. So, good thing that I got access to potions, because without potions that would have been pretty difficult. Now let me go and just update the save that I made here. Now where was I going? This way, right? Is this a door? Yes, it is. You can see how there's like a outline of a door right here that you won't be able to find elsewhere on these walls. So, yeah, you don't always need to use the map. It's just quicker to use it, more convenient, but yeah, like you don't have to keep like such a discerning eye out. Not the people I'm looking for either, but yeah. That is probably an archer. Yes, it is. Right, I forgot I cannot carry more stuff. I'm just gonna go ahead and rest here. My running has improved, of course it has. Of course, unfortunately I cannot carry more stuff, otherwise I could have taken a lot of the stuff. Good thing is, I mean, I've got ebony and adamantium sabers now. Like, one of which I can sell and the other I can keep, so... I mean, it's not a bad deal at all, if you ask me. I've already been in there. Yeah, this section was grueling. I hear on the werebow. Right here? Nope, that's not a werebow though. Yeah, so this is like a trick that you can use to get the opponent to move towards you after you keep hitting them. I tend to forget I cannot carry more stuff. It's only sad how I cannot loot anymore. Ah, so this is where the lift came down. Got it. So, do I go here? I guess I do. I do not think that is a door. It does not look like a door. It's just a dead end. No, it is a door. It is a door. It very much is a door. Yet I thought it was a door. Nah, that's just the wall. This is just the shape of the wall. It's not actually a door. Okay, let's go. Let's see where else this werewolf could be. This werewolf, sorry, not werewolf. Okay. Nothing here, of course, there's nothing here. Yeah. You need to keep checking. That's a spider. I'm surprised the spider didn't die in one hit. That's like big for the spider. Let me just go ahead and like mark this room as explode, otherwise I'll come back later here all confused. All excited that, oh yeah, that's where the objective probably is. I never explored that room. Yes, I did. I just forgot that I exploded. Yeah, I'll come back here. I'll come back to you. Yeah, let's explode the side first. Of course it's nothing. Like a whole lot of nothing. So this is the aspect of Arena which I both simultaneously enjoy and dislike. It's gargantuan labyrinthian. Oh, I needed you. I needed you. Let's see, what can we put here? This is just mithril, of course. I'm gonna remove this in the wagon. Now this. As far as like the weaponry goes, do I want to keep like an adamantium broadsword with me? Did I not pick up the like? Oh wait, it's in magic items, isn't it? Yeah. So I got consumed there for a second, thinking that maybe I did not pick it up. What? Yeah, these are practically useless to me right now, so I'm not gonna be carrying them. Like, visit lock. Locking doors is something that I would honestly not do as a warrior. I would rather fight, for one thing. And, yeah, it's just not something I would do as a warrior. So right now I've got like 3 weapons. I'm wondering whether or not I should just keep this back, because weapon durability in Daggerfall is pretty good on its own. So yeah, I think I'll go and just put this into the wagon, because I want to level up my blade right now. Okay, so we went like full circle already. I think I'm just gonna go ahead and check out this room as well, because I'm pretty certain that there's nothing in there. Like, since it is like a one-to-one copy of the room downstairs. So, in the end, even though I said that this dungeon does not seem to be one of those long winding ones, it turns out to be exactly that kind. I hope you're glad for, proving me wrong. Oh, so this was where we... Fine, so we came out here and we had like kept proceeding downstairs. I really, really wanted to check out this, side. I wanted to come here and see what was here, hoping that maybe the werewolf was here. But apparently, we found our way there anyway. So, nice. They're like, this, not one, but they're like literally... Two hanged men in this room, and oh my god, this is grim. Well, I heard something there. Are you a werewolf? But I'm guessing you were not the werewolf that I was looking for, because otherwise it would have told me. Yeah, it would have notified me otherwise. I'm sad that I finally found a werewolf, but it was not the werewolf I was looking for. And this is like a pretty nice room, actually. Sad. Well, what does this do? I wonder. Do I want to mess with this? Yes, I sure do. Yeah, let's go down there. Let's see what happens. Let me save this. I feel like... Oh yeah, I did recently save, but let me just go ahead and update that save anyway. Excuse me? Oh, I'm standing on something. Right. Can I, like, start jumping instead? Well, this is not... Good thing I saved here. Oh no! Oh no! And I overwrote my save. How foolish of me. Now, yeah, there was nothing there, so no point in going back there. And I do believe that we were headed this way. Can you die, please? Thank you, finally. Wow, took off half my health. Like, barbarians are crazy strong. Never underestimate them. I'm just gonna go straight for the... There's a spider behind the sword, but I don't think I'm gonna disturb him. Let him be, there's nothing in there anyway. Where did I go from here again? I think it was this direction. Yes, it was. Yes. Now let me put the rest of the stuff back into the wagon. And yeah, that should be it. Let me just go and save here again. Because, well, I sort of goofed up on the last save there. And let me just, for the record, sorry, not here. Yeah, let me just mark this area as well before I proceed, and while I'm at it, let me just go ahead and rest here. but not fully healed. And with that, my time to play has come to an end. I'm afraid I'll need to stop playing right now and go ahead and sleep. I wish I could keep playing the game more, but unfortunately that is not in the cards for me. Thank you for dying. Yeah, a very grim room. I do not like this room at all. I'm guessing that's like another lift to someplace. There you are. Sadly, you are not the target. Which makes me really sad because you are a werewolf as well. I just wish that you would the original intended target. Anyway, that is the end of the live for me for right now. I will be joining you guys again, even though it will be like just a cut for you guys. Not even a cut, I'm sure. But anyway, until next time, take care. Actually, I should not be saying that. Yeah, see you guys later. Yeah, so we're back, and this is the same room where I killed this werewolf. I've already covered all of this in previously, so I'm not really going to go into too much detail here, but yeah, get the point. So, where are we going right now? Right here, right. The question is, do I want to go here? Here's the thing, I know there's something down there, because, well, I got stuck on it. Last time I tried to go down there. Ah, it was you, was it? Can you die, please? Thank you. And I guess I'll have to search you more thoroughly for that. This is a brand new day. Unfortunately, I did not have too much time to record today, so I'll do the best I can with whatever limited time I have. You're just not sure, nothing more. I can hear a werewolf behind me, but yeah, I'll get to him in a while. This is one expansive dungeon, and well, as far as expansive dungeons go, this is pretty well. Nothing to fear from me. I can hear a werewolf behind us, so I'm just going to be cautious, even at the expense of the integrity of this, maze. As long as this door opens, I mean. God damn it! This door takes some doing, doesn't it? Let's just go and equip this so that I can see the integrity of this thing. And apparently there are quite a lot of attack patterns that you can pull with this thing here. Wait a minute. Let me just go and re-equip this. Equipment mace, right hand equipped. Yes. I'm just gonna assume that you are a werewolf and not the werewolf that I'm looking for. Which is a little saddening, but okay. Is this like a hidden door of sorts? No? Just an extra area, then I assume. Nothing else. Nothing there. I suppose the other elevator takes us to the other side then. This way? Yeah, this way. Let me just go ahead and update that save here. Yeah, I'll save it here. Since we actually did make some progress, so no sense in overwriting it. Now this one as well, I'm just gonna go ahead and that one cost me a lot of health points. You know what, let me just go ahead and reload that save. I mean, considering the fact that I'm saving before I take the elevator anywhere, I think it would be safe for me to actually go ahead and, you know. Oh, this is where it leads. Fine, right. And I do believe we have explored most of this area, if not all of it. Yeah, we have explored this area in its entirety. So, yeah, I do not suppose this elevator does as much good then. Yeah, there were some areas in the top floor which I think I missed exploring. So, I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna explore over there. Grim Room. Not a place that I would like to come to. But it would seem that at this juncture we have covered most of this, you know, dungeon, but to no avail really. I don't think I've been this way before, have I? Wait, where? Yeah, that's the dungeon exit, so... Oh, it's strange, I thought I actually came here through one of the areas here. You know, one of these entrances. But I guess I could be wrong. I guess I came through here then. So I guess let's just try going here and see. No, this is the path I took to come up. So, yeah, and there are two paths here. Let's check on the left first. Which is of course nothing. Good to get that cleared on the map, like that there's nothing there. I can see something in the store, probably a spider. Oh wait, this was the tunnel that I took to come up. Yes, 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 because there's literally a spider right next to it. And yeah, so what I need to do is take this left, because I don't think I've been down here. This door is open. I do not think there is a door here. Yeah, there isn't a door here, so it looks like I've been here when I never have. So yeah, let's keep continuing to explore this area. I'll save here again. I mean, I can hear somebody behind me, and I would just like to be a little cautious while looting this guy's body. Mithril lock, so could definitely keep that. No issues there. Mithril boots, +7, +7. Not bad. I mean, I could keep it as a spare as well, just in case. Although, I'm most likely going to sell it. And 36 gold pieces on this gentleman. Do not think I've been here before, but yeah, it's one of those labyrinthine areas of the dungeon. And, ooh, that was Barry on this woman's behalf. Rogue, no wonder. They're always good with berries, aren't they? Let me take all the gold. And I do not think this room has any hidden doors. They actually changed the engine between, you know, Daggerfall and Arena, and I'm sort of baffled how they did that. Like, in the span of 1 year changing engine cycle, that's like a huge achievement in itself. I think we have been to these areas here. So this is one of the areas that we had previously not visited, I would suppose, because this area seems like completely visited. So yeah, this area has been previously visited. Now, just to make it clear, this part of, I think, the map we have not cleared out yet. or unless it was the part of the map where that leads to. Yeah, I think this is the part of the map that leads to the entrance. Yes, it is. So, nothing there. We have already been there on the like previous save. Nothing over there. Where else have we missed? Let's go procedurally. This area seems to be unvisited. You know, this area of the map. And how do we get there then? Where are we? We are all the way here. So we keep going straight and we take a left, we go up there. Does that area even lead there? I think it might, but it might just take a little bit of doing. Because I think even this area has not been previously visited. No, but as far as this area is concerned, I think it is actually rather linked to one of the lower floors. The question is, how do we get there? See, at times like these, I really wish I had the smaller dungeon spot because navigating this mess would become so much easier with it. Yeah, I guess I'll just go back the way I came from. There's nothing up there we checked. And yeah, let's retrace our steps. Let's see which areas we have not been to thus far. I mean, that seems to be the better option right now, considering everything. So the dungeon exit is this one, north. Wait, did I drop all this? Oh no. Yeah, let me take as much as I can. Fine. And I'll keep putting them into the wagon. You please, you too. Thank you. That is not at all what I meant to do, but okay. Yeah, I'm not... Oh yeah, it's ended here, over here. No, I do not want to... Oh, come on. Excuse me, I'm just a little that bit sleepy right now. And that is more or less... Access your wagon, yeah. Is more or less, you know, factoring into how I play this game. Very clumsily. Yeah, I think that is good. And what else can I take from here? I can move these into my inventory. This as well, this as well, this as well. Right. Apparently the sword is heavier than... Yeah, apparently arms are heavier than armor, which is quite strange because I would have thought that like armor is heavier than arms, but I guess not. I guess that isn't how it looks in this game. And hopefully this would be the last of it. I made a very fundamental mistake there, which I tend to make quite often actually. So I'm sort of glad that things worked out the way they did. Otherwise it was gonna be like pretty damn, you know, heartbreaking. So yeah, let's save on top of this. And I think I went straight the previous time around. after getting that rat. And let's see where else we have left to go. This is just one of those quests where you have to search a lot. So let's see where I've been here. I do not think we've been straight. We did explore that area of the map, but we have not explored the part that goes straight. So yeah, let's go straight up. Let's see where this leads us. Pretty sure it'll lead us somewhere where we've already been, but let me just go ahead and update my save, since I slept and like rested for a little while. Or not, I mean, this seems like a new area considering this barbarian that we just faced, who was actually pretty easy to defeat, surprisingly easy. But this looks stylish. I honestly wish more armor was like this instead of, you know, just being one color. I mean, armor should have like a trim color as well as a base color, otherwise it doesn't look as good. Oh, okay, it's that place. And which way have we not been here? I think we've been both ways in this place. Like all ways we could possibly go. But we could not find our werewolf. But this looks like another place that we have not been yet. And to get here, we'll need to take the path to our right, which is not this path. Okay. Huh. Well, this guy came to greet me, telling me that, hey, you have not in fact come here. Please swing by more often. 36 gold pieces on the man. Apparently, I have come here just. Not in the same fashion that I thought I did. Yeah, so we basically need to go up here apparently. That's one of the places that we had not previously explored. What the fuck just happened? Excuse me? Did you see the Lich kill me? I'm not prepared for that difficult an opponent, come on. Yeah, let's take a gold and I would like to make a separate save here for the emergency save. Because let me see if I have potions of like, I don't know. Cure shock or something? Because god damn, that guy was difficult. I did not expect him to be that difficult, honestly. Excuse me? Yeah, you know what? Let me try a new strategy here. Let me try it with the bow and arrow. I think one of the reasons that this guy is so effective Okay, so the material of the weapon I'm using is ineffective. Right. I can use like a potion of reaction. Not that it'll help, but I can equip this, but I do not think I'll go to step into melee range with this guy, because that's how he gets me. Oh, there's a Daedra there! No wonder this guy's so difficult. Excuse me, I want to move back. Thank you. This kind of stuff. Holy shit, this was difficult. I'm gonna rest here until I'm fully healed. There's no way I'm not gonna do that. Now what does this lich have for me? 657 gold pieces? He better. I'm gonna save the game here as well because no way in hell am I doing that again. There's like a barbarian here, and why does the barbarian have an evening gown? Like, that's like the randomest loot possible. There was like a rat there, a barbarian there, and like one of those, I don't know what it was, I think like vampire or something. I had a daedra, I think, to top that off. My god, talk about difficult. I mean, if I didn't have potions, I probably would not have made it. I think we have been here before. Yes, we have. Oh, so it was the other side of the road that leads you down there. Fine. Sadly, at this point, I think we have covered most of the map, if not all of it. So the question still remains, where do we go? That's where we came from. That's where we went down. Okay, let's keep pressing forward. Maybe we'll luck out and find something. Who knows? Back up, I guess. Like, we are sort of retracing our path, aren't we? By in doing so. I mean, we have been here before. We have completely explored that part of the cave system as well. Not the cave system, rather the dungeon, which turned out to be completely fruitless. And we go deeper. I mean, I did kill a werewolf, but I do not think it was Cyndassa's werewolf, because otherwise it would tell me. Usually it does, but even though we certain about it. I guess we can try going down this hole, because that's one place that I've not been yet. Okay, let's save in the emergency save and jump down, I guess. And we did take like quite a bit of fall damage from that, but I don't think we've been down here. I mean, I would hope not. Sounds like werewolves. That's a spider. Can you please die? Thank you. Did I? Interesting. I will come back to you, sir. Let me save here. Let me keep exploring, keep pushing forward and exploring. This is definitely not the target that I'm looking for. A rogue, well fought. For a rogue. But, yeah. That's the thing about these games, like... so there is a hidden door here. It's just loot and nothing else. Sort of disappointing. I was hoping that there would be a werewolf or something back there, but I'm guessing that's asking for too much. Oh, I completely missed this loot. Among, you know, all the darkness. I'll remove this. Probably looks like a dwarven dagger, yeah. I read it and said, that looks like a dwarven dagger. Okay, let's go up then. Let's see where this takes us. Somewhere I'm certain, but I'd like to move where though. Okay, it's okay. Yeah. We did see like a like an elevator shaft down there that we could have used, and this is pretty much what it was. Now the thing is, I didn't even click on the elevator shaft; it just sort of took me. I bumped into it, and it just sort of did the rest for me. So that was sort of cute, sort of good, but. Have we been all the way down there? Yeah, we have. So what area now remains? What area of the map now remains, I wonder? I can see something here that I've not visited yet. But the question is, how do we get here? Because right now, where am I right now? That's like another big question. Where am I right now? Yeah, so I'm right here. And if I want to get all the way over there, I'm gonna have to take this route upstairs. Yeah, and. Okay, it's not that long a route actually. So where am I going? I'm going west. Or east, rather. Yeah, my bad. I'm going east. Towards the hanging guy. The sad hanging guy. And where do I go from here? You take a right. Right. yeah, and we keep going up to that one room that I, for some godforsaken reason, decided not to go into. And I go to the very end of the hall and I take the left. Maybe it could have been that it was a hidden room of sorts. Yes, it is. It is a hidden door. Maybe the objective is right behind this. Who knows? Nah, it's just loot, that's it. I'm sort of glad that the door burst open at the first hit. But yeah, I mean, if these dungeons had loot, it would be like amazing, but these dungeons do not have loot. Now, which other area is remaining, I wonder? Pretty difficult indeed. Pretty difficult situation indeed. Now this looks like the area near the starting. I do believe this is near the starting of the Wait, is there something there that we have not yet visited? Seems like an open door, but nothing seen yet. Like, we have not visited inside the door. Maybe because it's like a tiny little room of sorts, but we never went in there for whatever reason. We have explored that part as well, I do believe. Yes, we have, in its entirety. Nothing there. Yeah, this is the entrance to the dungeon. Wait, there's a secret door there? We're here? Is this the door? No, a little bit ahead. This? No, behind me. But this door was well hidden. Okay, now what I would like to do is save before I... Yeah, I'm gonna save in the emergency slot. Before I hit this lever to go up. Spider came, spider died. That looks like some dead thing. Yeah, I don't think I've been either way. This way does not seem to have anything. This button sort of seems out of place, but yeah, I don't know much about it. To, you know, not enough to start forming opinions anyway. Yeah, I do not think there are any hidden doors here, otherwise the game would tell me. It usually does, so... That looks like a werewolf. Nah, that's just a werewolf. Getting my hopes up like that. I'm guessing the ones with, like, long ears are, werewolves? Huh, that is a strange thing. I wonder why the walls are all cut out like that. It's like supposed to be like a sort of battlement of sorts. Not my target, but I will kill you nonetheless. Of course, I can't rest here, but not that I needed to rest here, but yeah, I'm glad that I did. What is that sound, I wonder? Seems like something very... Are you done there? I don't know, you're sort of wall glitched, aren't you? Barbarian is dead. The Volvish Barbarian, I mean. With a mithril axe that is actually better than the axe that I currently have. So I guess I'll just sell the axe that I have and take these instead. Chain boots, nothing of value there. Steel weapon is actually steel saber, nothing of value there either. So I'm just gonna heal again because, well, that was a tough barbarian. As barbarians usually are, and yeah, this is seemingly a new area with old enemies. And if my objective is not here, then I do not know where else to look, to be honest. I cannot carry any more stuff, are you serious? Then again, I mean, all this stuff is pretty much gonna be, you know, worth far more than the pool that this guy can offer anyway. So I guess that was just an extra area, nothing there. That's an empty room with nothing there either, and that's again another empty room, and we go downstairs, and that's the place that we came from. Like, absolutely nothing here whatsoever. Yeah, I wonder why this woman was wall-glitched though. Pretty interesting. I did kill a werewolf, but I'm not sure whether that is Sandra's werewolf or not. You know, let me just go ahead and refer USB on this, because I'm really curious. I'll tell you what makes me really curious. All the other weird creatures that I've found on this level have been werewolves. None of them have been werewolves, except for that one guy that I killed there. And maybe it's a bug that doesn't show the message that I have killed the werewolf that needs killing. So yeah, let me just go ahead and check. I'll be right back. Okay, so I looked up in UVSB and well, The only thing that's for certain is the fact that, well, we have to keep looking. Just because we found a werewolf doesn't mean that's our werewolf. Because if it was, the message will certainly pop up and there is no mention of a bugbear. It doesn't pop up the message. But unfortunately for me, I'm out of time today. I mean, I was already short on time today. So I don't want to drag this out too long. And yeah, I will come back later. See you guys then. So she takes it, news, I mean. It's dead then, is it? Poor thing. He used to be my brother. If you ask me, he died long ago when he first got bit. He hated himself when he became that beast. I wish there'd been another way to help him. I promise I'd tell you about that letter you're looking for, didn't I now? Of course, I remember that letter, Grimfangs. It's not every day that you get a letter from the Emperor himself, especially seen as the king ain't too fond of him. Fact, that's the only letter I've seen from him. I gave it to Her Majesty, and she's all excited and she rip it open and says, "This isn't for me, this is addressed to Minnesota." Then boom, her jaw fall open and her eyes get real wide. She says she'll make sure the Queen Mother gets it and that I don't have to worry myself or none about it. And that's pretty much all she says. So, yeah, I mean, this quest was a little... it was a big hassle to find the werewolf, and it was pretty much my own fault. I mean, there were no hidden areas, just one of those areas that I had not previously explored. And that's totally on me. This is totally on me. Like, nothing else about it. So, yeah, that's it. That's that. So basically, like, a letter came from the Emperor, and it was addressed to Medicera, but the confusion began there, right? Because, well, the letter was addressed to Medicera, but why? I mean, I know why it happened, but the question right now is, why did the letter get delivered to, you know, Aubk-i instead of Minnesota? And so that's pretty much just one of the things about this, about the plot, about how that entire letter got misplaced in the first place, the letter to Barenziah that stems from this. And I guess we should probably go and talk to Minnesota about it then. But from the letter from the Emperor at that. So that was the information that we got from Cyssanda. And I wonder if it gets us access to Minnesota. Of course, she won't be talking to us anymore. You there. Can you tell me about Minnesota? You have at least mastered the minimum form of etiquette, but I just don't know. People. Polite. Minnesota. Okay. Pretty rude. Still pretty rude. And that was that for this quest. I unfortunately failed to capture the part where I slay the werewolf. That's again totally on me, because I was super fixated on actually looking for the werewolf. But at least I got to show you guys where the werewolf is. And I do realize that I wasn't commentating back then either. I'm just sleepy right now. My apologies for that. It's past 12:30. Trying to cultivate habits and stuff. But anyway, this video has gone on for long enough, and I do not want to drag it out any longer. So yeah, thank you for sticking around, especially on this video. This is going to be an insanely long video. I've sat down for what, like, at least 2 hours now playing this, 3 sessions. So yeah, most of it is going up. I'll try to trim it down as much as possible. And thank you for watching, thank you for sticking around, thank you for tuning in, thank you for subscribing. That's a stretch. That's a plug, a shameless plug. But anyway, thank you for all of that. And the next time we come back, we will probably be doing some nightly order quests, because, well, one of the things that I do want to do with this character is increase, basically fighter skill and knightly orders. And maybe if, you know, we want to take a religious angle with her, we might as well start worshipping Tipella. But that'll of course be after the end of the main quest. I do not want to do that before the main quest ends. But judging by my encounter with the vampire lich, vampires and ancient liches, I do feel it is not an overreaction for me to be wanting to, you know, increase my level and skills before to at least, you know, like 15 before I attempt the main quest any further. There's no rush for it, of course. So yeah, I think I'll be tackling either the Fighter's Guild or Knightly Orders the next time we meet. And that will go on for a while. That will go on for a while until maybe I'm bored of it or something. And then we'll switch over to, well, the main quest. And we'll switch back and forth here and there. It'll not be like a linear thing. So yeah, I mean, that's pretty much how this game was meant to be played. You're supposed to talk to people, level up, and do multiple different things in between while you're still tackling the main quest. So yeah, I think this, I've dragged down this outro for long enough as well. So yeah, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, thank you for sticking around until the end, and until next time, take care, farewell fellow earthlings.